definitely getting closer. It sounds like he's going out. in another tree. I'm just directly behind.
so grabs him his pen in that same spot. Yeah, I see his head sticking out. I don't know if they're flipping or something like that.
It was a tough one.
Look at that. 12 gauge knocked me out.
Huh?
Look at that 12 gauge. Knocked me out. I got up and was like, what just happened?
Yeah, I didn't know what you were doing.
Such a bomb. Gosh.
A long, not necessarily a long one, just a hard one.
Very, very difficult.
You think that's bird y'all hunted yesterday?
I've never in my life heard turkey drum as well.
Oh, really?
This is the only
turkey. It's a huge body turkey.
Look at that. That explains a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought he was in a road. That's why I looked up at the road and there wasn't nothing in there. I thought it was.
Oh. No, I saw him just disappear when you shot.
His head was behind that pine tree. See, I don't know, is that what that did?
No, it's...
But his head was, I mean, half of it was covered by a pine tree. I see him still got just a little bit. He still got just a little bit and he was behind some, like, I guess that grassy stuff. It was just covered up. I couldn't tell what it was. I didn't know what it did. I guess I'll see it.
Yeah. Sitting on two saplings.
I mean, the small saplings in there. I thought for the longest time he was right there, and I guarantee you he was back there.
Mm-hmm.
His drum was just sounding that loud. He sat up there yesterday, Will and Reed and I. I promise you from 1:30 to 7 o'clock. Listening to that, just drumming.
Yeah.
He got probably five times.
That's a huge body turkey.
I mean,
I gotta step back to get all of that, all of y'all in front of me.
It's the whole woods shoot.
Yeah.
Hey, we have, I told you, the only regardless of drumming, you can't miss the drums. And I don't think that either him or the hen would have come in without that wing bone for sure.
Yeah.
Something different.
Well, yeah, that wasn't on camera, but we popped the wing bone. And he gobbled up once,
huh?
And we sat down,
he
twice.
That's a big one. Body turkey. Feet.
Yeah, his feet are solid white.
Look at that. It's kind
of
cool.
I ain't never seen him that white.
Look at these. Look at this, the hard drumming turkey. Last spot. Home's for home.
Yeah.
Very close to going home. I ain't choked up. I can't
see. Dude, I was sitting there. I was going.
I was doing the same.
I said a prayer. I was like, please, Lord, just let him come out within the next 30 seconds because I'm about to die.
Let me get 30 seconds. That was an hour and a half ago.
Yeah.
Just drumming and drumming and drumming and drumming. Was it not like he was just dogging that hen, though? That hen? I mean, he was on a trail. Like, she's come back here, and he's still kind of following the trail. And, like, I mean,
he just kind of...
And she was hopping along.
Easing around, yeah.
But she was kind of skittish.
Yeah.
Like a doe would be. And we saw her, I guarantee the same hen. I saw a little hen over it. She had that kind of dusty red on her. And that one we saw just got out of field. Well, I was thinking yesterday something had to have been hanging him up.
Right.
That's what it was.
That hen?
One single solo hen. And that's the only time I've ever seen a gobbler just ignore calls, ignore everything. he responded with drumming, but he gobbled that one time a long way off. But even in the wing bone right there, 45 yards from me, didn't say nothing, but we did that for 6 hours yesterday.
Jeez.
We made a call. If he was, like, when we located him, he answered.
Right.
So that's all he would give you.
But, I mean, that wing bone's probably something he's never heard.
That's exactly right. But anytime we tried to work him, nope. Helicopter flew over, maybe.
Yeah.
He might gobble at that, a train. But nope. So, big ol' Alabama longbeard. You might have to pick him up.
Good night.
He's stuck. He ain't stopped strutting.
Yeah.
Probably March 15th.
Yeah.
I'm telling you. Yeah,
the big old chunk white like head. Yeah, I was just like, good night, he's big. Like, his head is huge.
Big old body. A pretty one.
Mm-hmm.
I can just pick the fucking thing. Sticking it out one more hour.
Right, I'll take it any day.
Stick it out in one more spot a lot.
Yeah.
Don't work out. A lot of folks don't get to see that. Chase gets tagged along a lot of. We've been here 2 days extra already, and there's still one more spot that I want to recheck. And most times it don't turn out like this.
Mm-mm. What I do, it's worth it.
Yep. I'd do it again. And it just makes it worse.
Mm-hmm.
You know? It's the ones that work out and make life a lot harder when it's time to get home and you're tired and stuff, and there's one more spot you could check. If it never worked out, it'd be a lot easier to
just roll on. Yeah.
Have a lot more sleep. We tend to like the business probably, but this one will hang around for probably 5 years or five more years of checking one last spot.
Yeah.
Because of this right here. When I say I'm tired, I don't get tired too much. I'm born to slap out. It's been rough.
I got a cough. I'm putting the camera down for a second.
I got a bottle of water if you want.
I'm going to need a swig of it.
My throat was stuck together. I just have a very hard time believing a 2-year-old.
Yeah, why he acting?
He's got like 3-4 inch spurs.
Yeah.
Maybe a 9-inch beard.
Got a big old body.
He's still shit.
I'm telling you,
he's freaking stripped.
Fired up, fella.
You flip your thing up, make sure we're on it.
We're out.
You know? Just me. Last time I did it, we just got our boots. And even here is not as good as you will. That's a fascination with the head. I've seen Miriams and stuff have a snoot at all.
You have not.
That Joker. I've been feeling it. I thought I missed him.
No, yeah, he looked at me like, and I'm like, go get him.
You said something like, yep, like, or something like that, like, yep, you blew it, or something.
I felt like the look on your face asked me, did I get him?
I guess, there's got to be, this is where he was, I'm guessing.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he didn't flop by nothing?
No, I mean, it
just stone cold him.
Mm-hmm. And then I heard his feet.
Really?
Like three times.
I thought he was running. I heard that. Yeah. But I'm saying,
I was just like, good.
Where are we sitting? I'm telling you, I think it knocked me for a loop. I was so turned around. But I was also, my feet were this way. One was this way, and I'm doing this. Yeah. So when I stand up, I'm back to
you. Yeah, you're like, what's the direction? Idea where I'm at. If you weren't already, directionally.
Oh, right.
Yeah, whatever.
But I swore he had, this was, I guess he was walking down this. But I was thinking this was the embankment to the road.
I mean, it kind of is. The road's not 15 yards. Well, I thought the road was a lot closer. Yeah. I thought he was about to pop out in the road.
For some reason or another. And I looked at, looked in the edge of the road. And
I have no idea if he's on camera.
That's all right.
The camera's facing 100% sideways and my viewfinder's on the back.
If you got that, that's talent.
Because I know it's shaky though. I'm
we had a bead on him from the drumming and still had no idea where he was going to come out. I knew he would get up here because he got up here yesterday. And I thought, I mean, surely there's a downed tree, there's a creek, a ditch, something that I don't know about. Keeping him hung up. I tried silence, tried cutting up, moved around, moved back, went home, came back, everything you think of. Got down in his grill, about 6:30 or something, just kind of kept my gun on my shoulder. I was just observing, not trying to bring him anywhere, or make him do anything, just being a fly on the wall so we can come back today. And I promise you, see that brush pile over there?
Uh-huh.
I was up in it. I went all the way down the creek, put that brush pile between me and him. He was in his bottom, and I knew, he was in the bottom. Got that between us, and surely I'm going to see him. I knew he'd gotten high a couple of times. And I promise God, he gobbled a couple times right here, and I could not see him. I thought, it's a goat. I don't know what else to say. There is no explanation. There's nothing I can do differently. There's nothing I learned. I'm going home having no idea where he is. What if it's a Jake, if it's a longbeard, if it's got hens with him, how many it is, nothing.
Yeah, I mean, it's a weird little bottom.
It is high. It's a
little
bowl.
Holes in it, huh?
It's a bowl.
It is kind of a bowl.
And I was thinking that's why his drumming was loud, but he got up here and was drumming and about booming his drums out. He gobbled one time and then drummed right after, and I promise, there was no difference in decibels.
Nuh-uh.
The goblin and the drum was the same. I don't know. That might not pick it up as well.
It ain't going to. Yeah, probably ain't going to pick it up at all.
But, it's the loudest drumming I've heard. And I've heard three or four that I just remember.
Mm-hmm.
Me and Jordan Blissett hunted one in whatever it is. Fort Gibson area with seals and lake 2 years ago. And until now, that was the loudest drumming I've ever heard.
It
shook the woods like this. But this one, I promise, is twice as loud.
Let me check that camera. Make sure it's still recording with us. 30 minutes.
That's a beautiful head. Got the yellow beak. Most of them are just white and gray. They got him good.
He's out for a minute.
When I see him stuck like that, it's almost like they didn't hear the gunshot at all. They didn't have no suspicion at all. Their snoot is
was on the other side of his head because he was looking up here too. Because we called up here the first time and then we walked downhill actually to try and level the playing field, I guess.
He will forever reside with the long snood.
Uh-huh.
He never got nervous. I don't know how far that is, 30.
Maybe. I'm trying to remember.
I have no idea.
See the tree again.
Half my stuff. I didn't even bring a vest.
Yeah, I mean, we literally came here just to see if he's here.
Yeah. I was not hoping he wasn't, but I could not go home without knowing that he wasn't. What if he is in that bottom again, drumming, and I got to listen to it all the way back to Georgia? In the back of my mind, instead of, at least show you, hey, listen to this.
Yeah.
We can go home after. I just want you to hear this turkey drum.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm told he was out here drumming.
That he was.
Yep.
And you heard it before I did, I think.
Yeah, I heard it up the road a little ways, but yeah. I couldn't tell if it was. I thought I was on that side of the road.
I was.
But there was also may have been a log truck.
Well, we're in these rivers, creeks, and swamps, and everything just touches each other right here. Somehow there's not a bunch of water.
That's what I still don't
know. It's all contained in the canal type structure of some kind. Or a bank. But it's how cool do you think it is down here? It's, I know the real feel or whatever it is outside of these woods, 88, 89, when we got out of the truck at noon. I mean, what time is it? 1:30?
I don't have a phone.
1:30 maybe?
Maybe. Yeah.
I got a watch. I was nervous about my watch. I forgot to take it off.
All my camera gear was in the sunshine. I was like
25.
125.
That's Eastern time, I think, though. I'm not positive.
I mean, we were probably on him 30 minutes, though. Like, it kind of worked out fairly quick. We ain't been in here an hour, I don't think.
I feel like I'm on hour 9 because I was in here 8 hours yesterday.
After this morning, I feel like hour 9 myself.
They whooped this morning.
Left, right, good. And side road. Right.
And they did exactly what I thought they were going to do.
Yeah.
And they still, you know, it's one of them. The worst kind of whoopings is giving it your best shot, punching somebody as hard as you can, and then not phasing. Usually that's all I got. And they didn't check up. They did exactly what I thought they were going to do, and they did it anyway. There wasn't much we could do about it.
Yeah.
And this one whooped us here. Didn't have to bear it. But there were several times I was twisted in a knot like that, thinking he's coming up here, he's coming down, and he's about to pop out. I held my gun freehand for longer than I ever in my life. My shoulders are killing me today.
Yeah.
Because he's about to come out, he's about to come out, he's about to pop out of this tree. He's on the road now. Now he's about to come over this knoll, and never did, not once. And so today, I remember just thinking, like, what have I done? Like, I'm doing this, freehanded going, he's about to pop out of this knoll. Like, am I an idiot?
Yeah. Well, that's why we went to get a Gatorade or whatever. And
we came here and
I was about to sleep,
turned around and was like, no, we can't. I'm worn out. I got there and I got to thinking. I was like, all right, come on, let's go.
But yeah, I was about half asleep in the truck. Okay. I was like, you really want to? I didn't say it, but you knew I didn't want to get out of that truck.
I didn't really ask, you know, because I knew if I asked, you're going to be like, We can't, you know. I'm not gonna say anything, but I'm gonna be pissed when we go in here. So it's not like I know where an easy turkey is. One whooped me real bad yesterday. You wanna go try him right here the last 30 minutes? And you know my bus will stay here for 9 o'clock if it takes that long if we do hear him.
That's where I was like,
please don't gobble.
I heard something I thought was a gobble at the first time I hit a call and I was like, not saying
that's way too far. That's
not even
gonna make a hunt out of it. And we're supposed to be listening.
Yep. But and even when we did hear him gobble that time, it was kind of like, was that a gobble?
Yeah. And him gobbling there was odd.
He sounded far every time he gobbled. He may have still been a little far. He had a big bottom.
It is big bottom.
I figured he would have been on another ridge.
I mean, you look over there, it's identical. And it's about a 1 foot declination for 15 yards tops.
Yeah.
And, you know, picks back up to normal. That, I mean, drops off 25, 30 feet. And just goes into a bottom. You would never know it walking down this road.
Nope.
And then picks back up over there. If you didn't look over it, you'd think that's just normal road.
That's what it is. It's just the road, and then it rises a little bit enough to match the
and if you're walking on
whatever
radio, no
the other side and it looks flat.
Supposedly there's a road that goes down this way and it's supposed to cross a creek right here. Because I mean the original whole story on this turkey, this one right here, is Will and Reed and I set up on him about 12:30 yesterday. And a half a mile walk around the big this is an old cotton field or something up here, but there's a big gully, and this is, we're in the big gully right now.
Oh, okay.
And if you look just straight across, if you just threw a dart all the way through and it never sank, you'd hit where we were sitting, just parallel. Mm-hmm. We didn't go to the bottom. We got on halfway. I think it's about 450 yards, and we were going back and forth, moving back and forth. He sounded like he was 100 yards, and I could say 300 yards.
Yeah.
But, so we opted into coming down here, coming down this road. He said, there's a road that goes down here, this little intersection of just terrains, pretty much, with creeks and ditches and two roads and a field and a bottom. I've never seen that before, but all right,
yeah.
You know, but sure enough, that's exactly what's going on around here. And we came down here, and then we spent an hour and a half with him there. Just back and forth, back and forth. And we knew a creek was there. We just wanted to see what he would do, because he was on fire.
Yeah.
He gobbled them. But
as soon as
we got here, he's like, close enough now, and, you know, walk on up. That, or he didn't want that hen to know.
Mm-hmm. That's what he's actually gobbling at.
But I do wonder if that's the hen we saw in the field the past
good
2 days. What I'd do to bump her the opposite way, though, would be, you'd be in Mississippi, I'd be in Georgia, we'd be hanging out doing something. I'd be back in Orbis, probably. I would back up on them, staying there for a few hours.
It'll be alright. I know one thing, we left our thermosel laying down. That's the only thing we brought, binoculars, thermosel, wing bone, and alcohol.
Yep. I brought a box call just in case.
Yeah.
My mouth call, and I wasn't putting it in because I was scared to death I was going to choke.
I thought that mouth call was saved me.
I was like, you can do that wing bone twice, and we're sitting down, and I ain't letting him, because I think the hen was just taking him away, or was keeping him from even looking at us yesterday a lot, which I don't understand, because I would think she would try to get away, and unless he's trying to round her up.
Maybe get it round him.
Yeah, he's got to be a freaking pro, because, I mean, she hung around that long yesterday, apparently. But he drum and drum and drum and drum and drum. You know, that fast, that's one another.
Oh, yeah, it was considered like constant.
Doom. You know, it wasn't a break, no looking around. He walked and drummed. Boy, he's got to be hungry. He ain't stopped to eat in 2 days that I know of. Still stuck his stray. Pretty cool. Alabama has been a tough one yet again. Y'all got a good one yesterday, though.
Yeah.
That's a really cool one. Coming in that close. It's one of them, you go back to it like we did today, and I'm like, how in the world do they call a turkey out of here?
Yeah. That wing bone, man.
That was a wing bone. That's two wing bone turkeys.
Yep.
Well, you on the gun next, and I can't use a wing bone, so I don't know what you want me to do. I can use that scratch box, though.
Yeah, it's a scratch box y'all got those more.
I realize we're gonna be here a little longer now, we gotta skin it and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna be home late. But worth it, I think.
Oh, absolutely. Maybe I'm off color then.
She really does. Wait. And more white feet.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's a circulation thing or diet. Seals has had it, but he had no beard. So
yeah, he had.
I figured something's kind of just correlated there. But he got them sawed off wings, I know that.
Mm-hmm.
There it is. It's pretty. It's a bunch of gold. Appreciate it, buddy.
Glad to be here.
Makes a couple for us this year.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's fun about to start traveling and seeing new stuff. You get a good taste of it too. You get to shoot first, so that's gonna be good.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. See if my feet'll work.
Huh?
See if my feet'll work.
Mine are permanently distressed or something. As many times they fall asleep the past couple days. Mm-hmm. Grab our. We ain't bring nothing else.
I can go get all that. Here. Here's my shotgun stuff.